Hello and welcome to my third episode of my Startopia playthrough. This is episode 3, the Targ Collective. We'll start by seeing
you've become an employee of the Targ Collective. It's not so much a job, more a way of life. Anyway, your task is to set up a cargo trading facility. You must then trade with any passing merchants and store 100,000 energy. The Targs have provided these hard plan facilities, and generous souls that they are, will credit you with 50,000 energy when you build the energy collector.
Okay, so if you are new to the series, what I pretty much do is play the games through straight with audio commentary, try not to block anything by talking over anybody talking in game. And if you are old to the series, well, you know what I do. What I'm doing now is placing my energy collector down on the side because it takes up way too much space. And you can see our Scuzzer droids are busy once again constructing the energy collector. And let's actually go up to the entertainment deck. This is the entertainment deck. As you can see, it's got different color layout and whatnot. Let's go back down to the lower deck first and build a power booster. I'm going to build the power booster over here. And I'm going to build the port in the center. And I believe this is the center. And it sure is. There we go. And we'll wait. What we'll do is teleport our Scuzzer droids over because they are way too slow. And there we go, our port has been completed. We've got a couple more hardcore plans, Lavatron, Dinomant, Stardock. Alright, more basic stuff. Let's.
I have important news. The ever gracious Targs are providing 2 additional segments which you could occupy on this station. You will need to expand early in order to build a Stardock, one of which has been delivered along with additional amenities.
Now I can see that. I usually try to build the recharger on the sides of the maps because that's actually where the Scuzzer droids rest, as you can see. Increasing efficiency of the station. So we'll put that there and we'll get to work on that, and let's get our berth up as well. And now in this episode I'm going to try to retain some degree of symmetrical beauty. See that? I'll place the berth as such. This will be a little smaller berth than I usually build, but that is entirely fine, really. Because in reality, in Startopia, it is really better to start small and get bigger as you have more customers or aliens come to visit you, and whatnot. And we will try to localize most of the aliens in this location by placing Lavatrons and berths all in the same general area. And it looks like we can't place a Dino Man in the center, so. There we go, Dino Man's in the center, a Stardock. Now what a Stardock essentially is, at first glance, is a giant ass building that takes up lots and lots of space. And something interesting with the Stardock, you actually can't place it horizontally. As you can see, I can only switch back and forth. As such, it cannot be rotated. That's the right word, rotated. So what I'll actually do is put this up right against the wall over here. As such. Like that. There we go. And a comm sensor, of course. Now, you actually can't receive signals for the ship without a comm sensor. Pretty much what a comm sensor does is alert you of general activity within the space region. So if you actually have multiple comm sensors, you'll actually get more incoming ships and traders through the Stardock, so that's always better. And I guess that kind of goes to show, the Stardock is for visitors and ships to come and trade in your space station.
I have important news. The ever-gracious Targs are providing 2 additional segments which you could occupy on this station. You will need to expand early in order to build a Stardock, one of which has been delivered along with additional amenities.
So you can see what I'm gonna start doing first is hiring Targs, because we can't actually receive any type of ships at all from the Stardock unless we have some comm sensors up. So I'm gonna move one Scuzzer droid over there. And let's actually get some basic hiring done. I'll hire at least one gray, possibly one of the most talented ones. And this guy seems to be more generally well-rounded, so we'll go for him. And you need to have some fun. Oh, yep. This has actually never happened yet in the video, so I guess I'll explain it. Aliens will actually refuse to get hired if their needs aren't met, and right now this guy needs to have fun. You can see this is alien board.
If you hire some Targ communications experts, you'll be able to receive trade traffic. Then you can start. Sometimes other travelers pass by your station. If you want to attract such, administrator, I urge you to note the race of any merchants you deal with. Each race has certain goods they see cheap and others they pay a lot for. I have observed that our friends the Greys often.
So you can see that this is our first glimpse of actually being able to see into outer space from our space station. It is breathtaking to a certain degree. You can actually see planets and other universes and stars and whatnot orbiting around too, so it's very, very interesting. We'll definitely get more of a glimpse at this later on in the game. But it just goes to show the amazing scale and, not scale, but just the beautiful atmosphere that the Monkey Foot has created for the game of Startopia. And you can see that it actually does dock. Very interesting stuff, good graphics. And you can see that now I can trade with the Greys. So what I'll do is buy a sick bay and a Lavatron. And I think after that we'll send them on their way.
Administrator, do not neglect visitors to your station. You can, see that in a factory provided with the right technology plans. So you might want to buy a factory and a few of these technology plans in the near future. You'll also need salt hogs to work there. A factory requires 4 workers. I advise caution when buying from Arona.
Hello. Arona calling, how's it going now? Oh, I got some stuff. I just know you'll fall in love with. What a quick idea. Buy from me and I'll owe you a bottle of vintage diesel wine from the planet Terra.
So what I'm gonna do is I should buy a cargo hold and a factory, because deals, those are very, very important buildings. It'll allow us to be self-sufficient and not have to rely on Aurora as much, which is definitely a big plus.
A stock tape indicates your inventory is worth approximately 15,000 E.
So what we're going to do is create a small sick bay here in the corner. As you can see, it's very elongated. That's perfectly fine, but we will have to maximize our usage of this space to its fullest potential. And to do that, I'm going to put a diagnosis unit like this. The crisscross method of building sick diagnosis units is possibly one of the most efficient use of space, in my opinion. And we'll put another one right there in the corner. But you can notice that it is kind of bad in the sense that the sick bay couches are kind of all over the place, but it doesn't matter. Okay, so what we have here is the factory, which I'll explain later after it's constructed, and we've got a cargo hold as well. Cargo hold is exactly what the name implies, it holds cargo. And you can see that you can only place it on the walls. You can't place it here, you cannot place it in the center. You can only place it on the walls, so that's what we'll do.
A merchant ship has docked.
Okay, no, this is the best spot, I believe. And there we go. And you can see that you can just actually right-click on the spaceship itself when the trader is boarded and buy your goods from there instead of clicking on the mission objectives of the corner. And we'll buy one love nest because these guys are more recharged, and we'll send them on their way. And now, since we have a sickbay running up, we need a higher grade as well.
Merchant ship has departed.
I'll go ahead and do that right now. Well, looks like we have a lot of skilled grades this time instead of the... You know... You can see that every single gray wants entertainment, so what we'll do is we'll take our love nest and go to the entertainment deck and expand and build our love nest, because we need to start entertaining those graves, because we need a sick bay. I've gone over this in the first episode, but as you can see, you can't build rooms too large as such. This is pretty much the maximum size, as you can see, but we'll keep it a little small for now. This seems to be a good size. We'll make a two-way entrance, and we'll put our waiting chairs on one side, because it's a bit nicer to look at, I guess. Then we'll go with a crisscross pattern for the love chairs. Now two spaces are left, but you know what? Let's just leave it. It's totally fine. It seems we have another trader. Let's go down back to the lower deck. And we have our factory up, so first of all, what I'm going to do is hire some pigs, salt pigs. Guess that's what we need. Pigs work at the factory, and what a factory is, guess what? Surprise! Builds things. So right now, I'll actually give this away. You actually have a different building later on called the research facility or the laboratory, I believe.
A merchant ship is docked.
Which allows you to research technologies and whatnot. A factory, what it does is allow you to construct objects at a much cheaper scale than you would have to buy them for. But you do need a technology for it. So as you can see, like, if I go into hard plans, I can't build anything because I don't have any type of hard plan technology. For example, if I had the technology for sick base, I'd be able to build a hard plan for sick base. But why would I do that? I can just go right click and build it straight from the menu. But you know what? There actually is a positive reason to this. If you build through the factory, so let's say if I want to build a sick bay, I select a sick bay from the hard plan and build a sick bay from the hard plan. So that'll actually be cheaper than if I were to right-click, select sick bay from here, and then build it. Of course, it does take longer, but it is cheaper.
For buying goods to trade. You spend it all, your later earning power could suffer. I suggest keeping 10,000 spare as cash to trade.
So you can see now, since we don't actually have an energy collector, we're getting a lot of trash built up. So what I'm going to do is just pick this stuff up. Yes, salt hogs are coming to trade. That is wonderful because we need recyclers. You can see our lave layer is up, and we need to hire some sirens to work in there. And of course, they're all refusing to.
A merchant ship has docked.
Just wonderful. It's a bit ironic that I can't hire workers we need to entertain. Guess they aren't entertained. But anyway, recycler. We need a recycler. And that's all we'll buy for now because we're actually quite low on money. What the hell? Didn't I just. Okay, I can't afford a recycler. That is what's happening. That's not good.
Hey, you get it, use the energy. Treat yourself to something nice with it. But remember, I'll be back.
And the trader left.
And if you can't pay,
that's bad time.
I'll take your contract as compensation. You got me?
Yes, my visitors are bored, but we only have like one person working. I think we're gonna have to pull out the stops and hire really, really cheap people instead. Are you bored? God damn you, screw you.
There is a solar flare in.
Hello. A Rona calling, how's it going now?
Yes, thank you for coming with your overcharged things.
Why don't we cut a deal? Buy from me and I'll owe you a bottle of vintage diesel wine from the planet Terra.
We desperately need a recycler right now at this moment. And what are you doing? Your special interests are particle physics and cybernetics. Some hardcore stuff going on there. Oh, look, we finally actually have our cargo hold up. And oh god, it's the cargo hold. Okay, this I guess this is a good time to explain what the cargo hold actually does. It's obviously holds things, and you can see that it actually holds things individually, so I can take that cargo hold, I can put it there. Take that, put it here. That's manual, but what it... Scuzzer droids will actually go around, pick stuff up, and put it in the cargo hold so they don't rot.
Ship has docked.
Which brings up another topic, things can rot. Yes, medical supplies can rot, food can rot, pretty much anything in a box form can rot over time, so... It's good that, Scuzzer droids take care of that. Definitely, we'll see more examples of this being used later on. And when you're trading stuff with traders, you need to have the items in your cargo hold. So if I had three medical supplies in the cargo hold, I'd be able to trade three medical supplies with the traders. But if they're not in the cargo hold, I can't trade at all. And I do not need you at this time, so we'll just send you away. And we desperately need the recycling to be on. Yes, my visitors are bored, and what we're going to do is hire more sirens, because it's currently our only entertainment method. Fortunately, we're going to have to hire really, really bad people, because they... Oh, yeah, that's lovely. No, being entertained.
Supervisor, why not help your scuzzer droids by beaming up rubbish and junk and dropping it directly into the recycler? Or is such a menial task below you?
And let's check all of our residents, which are everybody that are hired. We have two Targs, a siren, and one salt pig. That's not very good. For now, while we get a couple of people entertained, we're gonna suck some garbage up. Because that's all I appear to be doing in most of my spare time. Yes. Okay. I think we do need a doctor. Let's check again if we have any greys that are interested in getting hired. Yes, there we go. Awesome. Let's get another grey. And you're bored, I'm assuming? Are you bored? Yep, you're bored. Oh, and the lavish run. Now, if you're noticing that the Scuzz droid's doing what appears to be waving at the people in the washrooms, but actually that's not what's going on. The Scuzz droid's actually doing is it's repairing the Lavatron. Now, why is it repairing the red Lavatron? That's because the quality of the building is decreasing because I don't have sufficient energy to keep it up. As you can see on the left top, you can see that this bar is a bit yellow. That means I do not have enough power boosters because buildings require power. So what I need to do is actually build more power boosters. But right now, that's not on my highest priority. I'm gonna build the disco, because I desperately need
yes,
entertainment, because I can't hire anybody.
Now, seeing as we got a special relationship, I would let you have first refusal on some tasty goods, what do you say?
Again, small note, when you buy things from a trader and you have a cargo hold, it won't go into your inventory, it'll go straight to the cargo hold, so remember that. And I'll build a disco, because discos don't require workers, and that's what I need right now. I'll build disco on this side. And I believe about this size should do. You can see I'm trying to mirror the other opposite sides. Three away from door. Okay, that seems good. Yep, that is exactly the same. And we need Scuzzer droids up here, Prano. And they need to build it quickly. And I think you guys will find the disco entertaining because it's quite a humorous room, really. And it's almost complete. Ooh, yeah. There we go. We've got a giant slime ball DJ. It's a disco room. We'll provide plenty of entertainment.
Your inventory is worth less than 500 each.
And let's hope these people are having enough fun to finally get hired. And yes, they are. Now we can finally... Actually, we'll leave the disco running up for a little bit.
Receive your reply.
Because people need to get a little more entertainment before we do anything.
A merchant ship has docked.
Oh, a nice salt hog. We'll hire him. And let's check how much workers we have. If we have one doctor, we need to hire more doctors. Definitely at the very least three or four. Alright, there we go. Two doctors, that's good enough for now. Oh, we got a three. There we go. We really can't hire more doctors because there's... Oh, another good doctor. Okay then. Okay, we'll stop hiring doctors now because we are running low on money. Instead, what I'll do is hire one Targ. This guy doesn't seem to have very good skills, but... Not much of a choice. Salt Hogs, we'll pick this Salt Hog. Dear God, that is one talented Salt Hog. Look at his statistics. Jesus. Skills are superb.
The merchant ship has departed.
Place is looking pretty good, eh? But I got some goods that'll make your eyes fall out and roll around the floor. And when you hear how cheap I'm selling them, your ears will drop off and slide back.
So here's an example. If I bought the Scuzzer MK1 technology, that means I can build Scuzzer droids at the factory. But I'm not going to be doing that because look how expensive that is. That is very, very pricey. So what I need is more sirens. I believe I need more sirens. Not many talented sirens, but I guess cheap is good for now. And yes, I am specifically only hiring female sirens because I really don't need male sirens right now. I mean, this room is weird enough as it is, and we don't have to turn the gay up at all, do we? Nothing against homosexuals.
The trader received your reply.
I hope nobody watching this is a homosexual. Not that I'm being sexist. I hope I'm not being sexist. I'll stop talking now. Okay, let's see. Factory cyclist. No, we do not need all this stuff. We need power booster. We need a power booster.
A merchant ship has departed.
So you can see we can make basic goods such as industrial materials, hardware supplies, and luxury goods. But we're not going to start doing that right now because we have no power at all. We need to start making some monies. Oh, I guess I never said this, but in Startopia, these little side panels you can see everywhere in every single like airlock is where the people go to teleport
stock
up and down.
Indicate your inventory is worth less than 500 E.
And we're doing a lot much better, and I'm pretty much just waiting for a trader or a robot to start selling a power booster, and from there we can work our way up, because we need to, if you actually don't have suitable power, all your buildings will slowly start degrading, actually, so that is very not good. That's terrible. More looking into space. Oh, look, a planet that looks like a very Earth-like planet, a Terran planet. It's definitely interesting how much work has been put into this game.
A merchant ship has docked.
Definitely an immersive experience, in my opinion. I mean, when I used to play Startopia by myself, I would just stare on hours outside in space. It's definitely a very mesmerizing experience. And there is no power boosters, so
there
we'll send those guys away.
There is a solar flare in progress. Shall I reconfigure the collector to gather some solar energy?
Seems we also seem to be needing another berth, because you can tell that a lot of the sleep things are filled up.
I've got some goods that'll make your eyes fall out and roll around the floor. And when you hear how cheap I'm selling them, your ears will drop off and
so we've got a power booster and a berth, and I think we're pretty much broke for now, so once we stabilize ourselves, we're gonna try to refrain from spending too much money. You can see that our shipments are coming in like that as such. You actually can't pick up your stuff until the robot places them. Power booster, and we'll put that in the same spot. As such, and let's hope our scuzzer droids get there as quickly as possible. Where are you going? Go over there and build that. You can see our power quality is dropping considerably. We desperately need to get this up higher. And a berth, we need to get a berth going too.
The solar flare has ended.
I think I'll create the berth on this side. As such. And I think that should be enough to cover most of our berth needs for quite some time. Gonna place the slumber pods first. Such, and there we go, that's perfect berth. Every single space taken up. Super high capacity. I'm very proud of myself. It's really all about placement in Startopia, you can see. I mean, none of the areas are blocked off, every single space is taken. I think it's beautiful. It's beautiful. This is what it's about. Pick up trash. Get them away. Let's check on the second floor, see how they're doing. Love Nest is relatively empty, but the disco is bumping. Put your hands up in the air.
A merchant ship has docked.
I think there's a time when I'm supposed to say something very, very funny and like beat myself to the music, but I'm not gonna do that. Because the game itself is amusing enough, in my opinion.
The merchant ship has departed.
Yeah, you can see that. We barely have any energy. Oh, no. So we need to definitely cut back on the spending.
A stock take indicates your inventory is worth less than 500 E.
But you know what? What we will do is actually go to the factory and start making some cargo. I'll make 5 luxury goods, and you can see that actually lines up. You can see that little 5 there in the queue. And you can see that in a factory only 4 salt pigs can be working at once. You can see that 1 salt pig is working right now. And let's actually check how many salt pigs we have as workers in the station. We have 3, that's good enough for now. Let's check our employment list. We have 3 salt pigs, that's pretty good. 4 doctors, that's definitely fine. 3 targs. Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and hire 1 or 2 more targs, because 3 targs can't be on at the comm sensor at 24 hours a day. And 1 more targ, and please don't be asleep. Alright. There we go. Siren, how are we doing on Siren? That's good enough, Siren.
A merchant ship has docked.
Power booster. We need 2 more power boosters. Alright. Because you can still see our energy is pretty bad. And I think while we're waiting for the robot to put our stuff in there, I'm gonna go ahead and hire 2 more salt pigs.
The merchant ship has departed.
Oh, I never took the time to explain to you guys what this stuff is. Okay. I guess I should do that now. Statistics for aliens. I think I already went over this, but, skill. Obvious skill, how well they're doing at their work. For grays, it's dangerous to hire anybody under 2 or 3 skill. I believe I usually generally try to only hire grays with 3 or higher skill. Dedication is how long they'll work at their workstation. Loyalty is actually in battle. We haven't fought yet. When we're fighting later, I'll explain this later on. But pretty much in terms, loyalty means that if an alien has high loyalty, he'll fight longer, maybe to the death almost. But if he has low or no loyalty at all, he'll just put his tail down and just run away like a whimpering dog. And we have our power boosters. There we go. Let's get this up. Which, again, brings up another topic. If you remember the last episode, you saw that one of my, health bays, sick bays, were in terrible shape, like somebody threw up all over it. That's because the building quality was degraded. If you don't have good power boosters or sufficient power boosters to power all your buildings, they'll slowly degrade over time. And you can see that buildings actually do have health. Which I can't show right now, but they do have health. You can see our luxury goods being transported and our Scuzzer droids carrying them.
A stock take indicates your inventory is worth approximately 5,000 P.
I can just steal from him.
The trader received your reply. A factory has completed its production.
Oh. What we're gonna do is, since they're finished doing that, let's actually go ahead and make more. You can only queue up a maximum of 9 objects, which is a bit bad. But you can always have multiple factories, so that's always a little thing to consider. You can see that this trade thing finally comes into play. Now I can actually sell goods, unlike where I could only buy things from before. So we're definitely getting a little more into the game now. What I'm going to do is buy more industrial goods, because the goal of the game is to get more goods. And you see, I only have 100 energy. That is really bad.
This is looking pretty good, eh? I've got some goods that'll make your eyes fall out and roll on the floor, and when you hear how cheap I'm selling them, your ears will drop off and slide back and fall as well.
So you can see that these smileys indicate how bad prices are. You can see there's two negative angry smileys. That means this is terribly priced. Like, this is a ripoff. I mean, this is like a salesman coming into your house, like, telling you that this new antivirus program is wonderful, even though on the back of the box it says Spyra 3000 model. And you can see the recharge is a little bit, a little worse, stuff like that. That's pretty much what the colors mean. You can see that Aurora is a fucking ripoff bastard, and even my luxury goods don't sell as much as it would for other races, because if you remember previously, this would sell for about 1,000, but now it's only 860, so you definitely need to pay attention to who you're selling to. To a certain extent, I did kind of go overboard with this berth. You can see it's not being used to its fullest potential, but regardless, I like to have really large facilities because it gives me such a large headway to have much, much larger stations. I don't have to worry about it for a very long time. Let's see, our disco's doing very, very well. We've got a lot of normal pedestrians hanging around. What I'm going to do is actually I'm going to buy a Lavatron, and I'm going to build that upstairs. Because Lavatron is one of those buildings where you can build upstairs.
A merchant ship has departed.
Entertainment bay. For some reason, I find myself always reorganizing the cargo bay. Small note, you can build multiple cargo bays too. So that's always something to consider. Oops. Take that upstairs, put it down on the ground. We'll build Lavatron here. Because, I mean, if you're dancing that disco all day, you know, you need to take a whiz occasionally once in a while. Alright, there we go. Back to the first floor. Our energy is still not doing too great. But, not much we can do about it. We got more luxury goods. That is swell. Teleport to the cargo bay, because these scuzzers are way too slow. And what we'll do is we'll actually add more luxury goods to for them to build. You can, with a factory, there's actually a certain acceleration with it. So let's say you had a couple of pigs in there and you just gave them the order. Like, when they first start, it'll be slow. Like, they'll make, like, a luxury good and, like, making now. Like, it'll be slow, but it'll slowly catch up and accelerate as they keep working. So it'll be now. Definitely not that fast. That's an over-exaggeration, but there's definitely some acceleration in there. So if you want them to work their ass off, you want them to keep adding more stuff for them to build constantly. Again, this isn't free. Using the factory isn't free. You can see that's costing me 650 energy per luxury good being built. But it is cheaper than purchasing. That's why you should do it. You see, our goal is having approximate cargo value of that much.
Hello. Arona calling, how's it going now? Oh, I got some stuff I just know you'll fall in love with. Why don't we cut a deal? Buy from me and I'll owe you a bottle of vintage diesel wine from the planet Terra.
A merchant ship has docked. There is a solar flare in progress. Shall I reconfigure the collector to gather some solar energy?
So definitely there's a profit margin with the factory. You can see that it costs me around roughly 600 energy, I believe, and my sell value is 750, so that's very, very good. But yeah, you know what? I'm not going to be selling because we need all these luxury goods to meet the game achievement. And now why am I building luxury goods? Because luxury goods are one of the most expensive type of goods. You can see that our quay has finished and our salt pigs are leaving. We don't want that. No, go back to work. Go back to work.
The factory has completed its production.
God damn it. Oh well. Let's go and check on our entertainment sector. You can see everybody's dancing as hard as ever. Go back down. And now, if I was playing a little more popular, I guess I would probably build more comm sensors because you're seeing we're getting a lot of like downtime with no ships coming at all. So I'd probably say 3 comm sensors would be a good amount. But yeah, I'll pretty much repeat this for now, and I think we're getting much, much closer to our goal. I believe, how much energy
this
do we need?
This is an historic moment. You are about to begin trading with the rest of the universe. Remember, the ever-watchful Targ Collective will only be satisfied when you've accumulated at least 100,000 E.
100,000 E, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 zeros. We are at 3, 4, 5. Okay, we're not even close.
A merchant ship has docked.
So what we definitely need to do is switch our goods over to something a little better, which are black market goods. Which I believe are one of the most expensive type of goods out there. I'll sell some stuff. Buy a power booster. Or at least try to buy a power booster. And a cargo hold. Because our cargoes are running a bit dry right now. You can see that people actually don't reject goods because if they have too much, he's saying that he has too much, so that sucks. Now I want to buy that power booster, but I can't because our cargo hold because our cargo hold is full. So what I'll do is I'll try to take some of this.
Is worth approximately 30,000 E.
No, wait, that's not it. Oh, it's because we don't have enough money for it. We need 3 more energy. We need 3 more energy to buy this cargo hold. 3 more energy, and yes, I got it. All right, now I can leave.
The merchant ship has departed.
Got another power booster. That's very, very good. I'll place that somewhere. Let's place it here.
A factory has completed its production.
We'll leave the factory for now.
Old pal Arona. Now, seeing as we got a special relationship, I would let you have first refusal.
You can see Aurora actually really loves black market goods. It's got a good price for them. So there we go. It's fine. So what we're gonna do is build our... Oh yes, where did my cargo hold plants go? I have no idea where I left my cargo hold plants. I think the scuzzer drawer took it back, but I don't see it in here. Is that it? I think that's it. Yep. Is that it? Oh, and by the way, if you just right-click on the cargo hold, you can actually see like a shortcut to everything you have. As such, definitely more organized. And we got another cargo hold, and we'll build that over here. Nope, doesn't fit. That sucks. Oh dear God! Every single corner has been taken up. We actually can't build another cargo hold. That's bad. Terribly terrible. Okay, so that's what we like to call bad space management. What I'm gonna do is actually maybe repack this room. This is called repacking. Repairing just breaks it down, you have to construct again. No biggie. And we'll get our cargo hold right over there. Let's see if our factory can actually fit. No, our factory cannot fit in the corner here. But it will fit over here. Thank God. Alright. You can see we're doing great on energy now. You can see that's pretty much in the green. So we're definitely at the out of the blue in terms of the buildings losing their durability too considerably. We know the cargo hold. Awesome, awesome. We're making much, much better progress now. Entertainment hold is majority really disco constantly. Nobody likes Love Nest anymore. I think I invested a little too much into Love Nest, but it's fine. Like I said before, I like that large heading, you know, if my space station expands drastically, I don't have to worry about anything.
Informed me that Arona will be back to collect his 25,000 loan repayment. You'd better get the energy together quickly. He's not a being to cross in financial matters.
You can see our cargo hold robot is actually just kind of chilling out, slowly floating around. Just thought I'd show you that. Then our comm sensor, Targ's hard at work. Just kind of staring at a beeping radar. Oh, hey.
It's your old chum Arona again. You're gonna love what I've got to sell. And you know that I always sell at that cheapest prices.
You know, I think we do have a considerable amount of money, so I'm gonna start actually buying some stuff. And what we're going to do is actually buy another port. You can actually buy another port, believe it or not, but I don't have enough money, so I'm not going to buy.
Supervisor, why not help your scuzzer droids by beaming up rubbish and junk and dropping it directly into the recycler? Or is such a menial task below you?
There we go. Sold some stuff, and we've got better. This is the Star Motel. Star Motel is exactly what it is. It's a motel, and we're going to build down their entertainment sector now. It's definitely a very, very big building, kind of out of place in my opinion, but what can I say? I don't know where to place it. I think I'll place it as such.
A merchant ship has docked.
Right there. That seems about good. Okay, medical supplies, I believe I've already explained this again already, but it actually improves the healthcare of your sick days. Now, sick days can run without medical supplies, but I don't think they run as efficiently, I believe. And there's a certain amount of diseases I also believe that can't be healed without medical supplies. Oh, of course, going back to it. When you look in your food, Dinomat, I believe I mentioned this in the first episode, you can enable biological food, real food, and mineral-based food. So what this is, of course, real food, people like it better because it's a healthier alternative, but also means you need food crates. You can see that in the factory, I can actually create that. Basic cargo. Actually, I can't. You know what? I'm gonna actually take this time to build more stuff in the factory. We'll go over it later. I'm sorry I actually brought it up. We'll definitely see it being mentioned in a later episode. For now, pick up trash, keep trading, make money. You can see our Star Motel is finished. Now you can actually adjust the prices of your buildings, as you can see, but I just leave it alone, because I haven't really seen any improvement or disimprovement for changing the prices. You can actually check the how much residents are in the Star Motel with the dots on the side, so you can see that it's 4 out of 9 here. They just kind of come out of this, like, swirling tunnel of death. Every time I come and do a close-up of the disco, I don't know what to say. I'm just looking at the disco. I don't need to say anything. I'm going back to my first look. Okay, more goods. All right, let's check. Oh, food supplies. That's what you need to sell real food at your restaurant. And people love real food. At least I believe they do. You can see that I enabled it, and that real food meter has filled up. You can see it.
It's your old chum Arona again. You're gonna love what I've got to sell. And you know that I always sell at that cheapest prices.
Yeah, cheapest prices my ass.
A stock take indicates your inventory is worth approximately 30,000 E.
Now I can't really show you like rotting footage because I don't have much stuff coming out, and I have pretty much a relatively high number of scuzzer droids compared to the amount of packages I'm making. But later on you'll definitely see what I mean by rotting packages. Port. Oh, I totally forgot about the port. Okay. Spare port. Okay. What I'm gonna do is actually temporarily close this port down, and. It actually, like, interrupts currently teleporting people. And do that. There we go. That way we keep everything constantly symmetrical. And we love symmetry here in my playthrough videos. Okay, we got another trader coming in, and a scuzzer droid should be constructing this fairly soon. Don't do that. Go build. To a certain degree, this is kind of like a roller coaster tycoon. If you delete your ports, your people in the station can't leave. It's like blocking your entrance off with a do not exit sign from Roller Coaster Tycoon 2, which everybody knows they've done once or twice. Or, I guess.
Ship is docked.
Building roller coasters with no end and killing people. That's also another fan favorite, I suppose. Low on money, so hold off on buying too much. Again.
A merchant ship has departed.
I actually think I might sell this or relocate the sick bay to a different location because I think I need to get another cargo hold in that area. Scuzzer droid, very, very awesome. Open it up. No, give this away. There's actually a different version of the Scuzzer called the Scuzzer MK2 and the Scuzzer MK3. The Scuzzer MK2 has a thread caterpillar wheels, which makes it much, much faster. And there's also the Scuzzer MK3, which is rocket boosters. And that's even faster.
Got the 25,000.
Oh, I don't have the 25,000. Oh, shit.
I'm a roamer again. You're gonna love what I've got to sell. And you know that I always sell at that cheapest prices.
There is a solar flare in progress. Shall I reconfigure the collector to gather some solar energy? Stock take indicates your inventory is worth approximately 35,000
E. We're doing pretty good. You can see that since we've expanded to 3 airlocks, that there's a giant bend in the space station when we look from here. I mean, that's like nearly 25
degrees.
Merchant ship
has departed.
It's quite fun to fly through like this in Startopia. It's even more fun later in the game when you get access to the entire station and you just can fly constantly throughout a giant circle. By the way, if you haven't known yet, Startopia is in a circular space station shaped like a donut. And I believe that you'll be able to see this in episode 3, not in episode... No, 3, this is episode 3, what I'm talking about, episode 4.
The solar flare has ended.
When we get access to the third level, you can see here, 1, 2, 3. 3 is the biome area, which of course you will see in a later episode, like I said. We're doing okay, since we got some money, and let's actually make more cargo. Because we want to win. Looks like another power booster or two might not hurt as well, because we seem to be in the yellow with power again. And another trader. Oh, look, it's a turn plant again. If you haven't noticed, plants actually, like I said before, they orbit, so... Yeah, you will see same plants over and over again. Well, at least in each individual save file. They do reset per game you play, so... It's not always the
same ship has docked.
System. Got some money, so I'll just buy stuff. There we go. In this mission, it's really all about just buying constantly, because I just need to have... Oh, look, we're almost halfway there, I believe.
A merchant
ship. Little before halfway. 40% or so. More luxury goods. You can see we're kind of in like a... Nebula kind of type of area.
It's me again, your old pal, Arona. Now, seeing as we got a special relationship, I would let you have first refusal on some tasty goods. What do you say?
I think I'll actually buy a dino mat in a general store or an entertainment district. Oh, and of course, I have to go.
Stock take indicates your inventory is worth over 40,000 E. I stopped counting after that, I'm afraid.
Right now we just have to wait for the car guy to do a super slow motion filling animation. Come on, give me that hard plan. Come on, come on. And there we go.
A merchant ship has docked.
Pretty much, it's really, as you can see, I'm down with money constantly. Like, I'm poor, because I'm just spending tons of money, just constant production, buying things, making luxury goods. You can see our cargo load is filling up faster than you can say abracadabra. Second floor again.
The factory has completed its production.
Well, thank you for telling me that. Dino mat, which I bought earlier. And I'll put that in the center.
What's in this room over here?
In the center is...
What's in this room over here?
Okay, whatever, I'll just put it here. No. Oh, is this the center? I believe that's the center, actually.
This?
Oh, wait. I have to put the luxury good away. And look at that, we're at 61,000. Is that it? That's such a large digit.
Place is looking pretty good, eh? I've got some goods that'll make your eyes fall out and roll around the floor. And when you hear how cheap I'm selling them, your ears will drop off and slide back and forth as well.
A merchant ship has docked.
In terms of a cargo value, approximate cargo value, I mean, I could definitely fill this up with other stuff like hard plans instead, but those are a bit more annoying to make. Alright, looks like we're filled up in cargo space, so I'm going to have to relocate this sick bay, which is going to be terrible because when I repack the room, every single individual object of the diagnosis units pops like that, so that's pretty annoying.
Supervisor, why not help your scuzzer droids by beaming up rubbish and junk and dropping it directly into the recycler? Or is such a menial task below you?
There we go, we've relocated the sick bay. And we'll go get our furniture back.
The merchant ship has departed.
And what is this, the waiting couch? Diagnosis unit, alright. Alright, just it's a placing game now. A little puzzle game. There's no reason to throw this away. I mean, it's perfectly worth the money. I mean, it is a little more annoying to rebuild this way, but it fits about money. If you can save a single piece of energy, I think it's worth doing. Is that food? Yes, that was food. No, cancel.
A merchant ship has docked.
Whoops. No, whoops. I accidentally picked up the diagnosis unit because it was blocking me. And I think that's it, yeah. I mean, I do have the centers are empty, but I think that's fine. Let's recycle that. And what we need is more cargo holds.
Ship has departed.
Okay, so right now I'm in some kind of very, very unusual dilemma. I actually can't buy anything because every single thing object is full right now, including my cargo. So I'm gonna have to sell one. I mean, recycle one of my objects.
Arona calling.
Arona, please have a cargo hold. Please have a cargo hold. Please have a. No, you don't have any cargo holds. I hate you, Arona. I wish you died in a fire. Sell some stuff. Alright, there we go. You can see they just magically disappear from the cargo hold. Let's check up on our second floor. Oh, trader, awesome. Oh, and litter everywhere. We need to clean this up. This is what makes the litter bin useful. You can see that the general store uses the items, boxes, you can see how much charge it has left.
The trader received your reply.
Oh, right, awesome.
Thanks. It's been a pleasure doing business with you.
Oh, I have trash. I should throw that away first. Okay, now cargo hold. That sucks.
Merchant ship has departed.
Well, I think I'd like to check up on how much residence we have now. Because it's been a while. Oh, and I'd like to describe to you guys what this actually is. It means people want promotion. So you can see, depending on their skill, dedication, and loyalty, that how that rank is. You can see this guy sucks at his work, so he's got a 1-star. This guy's like super crazy awesome, like super skilled, super dedicated, super loyalty. So he's like super crazy ranked up. When the star is blinking, it means that they want more money for their job. And you can do that by just clicking on it in the list. Only the blinking ones. It means you're giving them little promotions. And they'll have a slight happiness increase right when they get the promotion. You can promote them all the way to the top if you want to, like, full start, but it's not going to do anything. You can.
There is a solar flare in...
Alright, awesome. Let's ramp up on the production. You can see that now. Why am I making luxury goods? Because luxury goods are the most expensive, as you can see, which will make sure that our cargo hold value rises up significantly faster than if we were to use other goods. In theory, we can use anything else, anything at all, and put in the cargo hold. But as you can see, including everything, the luxury goods is still the most expensive. Love Nest Disco. No, this is not what we want. We want cargo hold. Yes, cargo hold. No, not enough money. We need to sell stuff. Alright, cargo hold. Yes, thank you, Aurora. Finally, you're useful. No, damn it! It lined up to the cargo hold thing, so it's gonna take forever for it to come out.
The solar flare has ended.
This is what shipping is like, kids. When you buy stuff, it takes 3 million years to get through the FedEx companies, and UPS, and USPS, and Canada Post. Goddamn federal postal workers.
A stock take indicates your
and there it is.
Worth over 40,000 E.
No, just put it in the cargo. Don't just give it to me because I'm right here. All right. I find it a little funny that Val is saying it's a little over 550,000 E or whatever, and he's saying, "Oh, I can't count over that." Well, he's a computer. I'm pretty sure that's not it. It's because the developers are lazy and they don't want to make more audio files. They don't want to make, like, you have 1 energy, you have 10 energy, you have 12 energy, you have 15 energy, 100 energy, 1,000 energy, 1,001 energy, 105 energy, 1,368 energy. They don't want to do that. No. They took the easy way out. And covered it up with light British humor. Nobody will look in there. You know what? The waiting game now. So really not much I can do other than pick up trash, so my station doesn't get ripped apart by giant evil monsters of death.
Supervisor, why not help your scuzzard?
It is quite annoying when the computer keeps saying to help pick up trash when at the very exact moment I am doing it.
The factory has completed its production.
Oh, really? Alright, well, guess what? You're making more. Yeah, that's right. You can see we got a new cargo hold. Sweet.
A merchant ship has docked. merchant ship has departed.
What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna actually plan ahead and relocate the star dock, which you can't do. Oh, I forgot. Yes, star dock is one of those buildings where you actually can't relocate because it's so important. Or wait, I believe if, maybe... Nope. Yeah, after the ship leaves, you can repack it. Because imagine a spaceship just kind of floating in midair. And I'll place that star dock right there, and we can get another cargo one on the side, just in case we need another one to finish the game. Looks like we're almost there, we just need 30,000 more.
Yes, yes, it's me again, your old pal, Arona. Now, seeing as we got a special relationship, I would let you have first refusal on some tasty goods, what do you say?
Dear God, this place is dirty. Of course, this will be remedied in later playthroughs with MK3 Scuzzadroids, which are very, very fast. Tons of them running around, produced by like two factories, which is usually what I do. And trash litter bins everywhere, which we the technology we don't have yet, which is a shame. You can see the quality of our port is dropping down, and that's probably because energy is a bit low, perhaps. And we have practically no money at all. Look at that. Look how tiny that blob is. That is sad. That's what it is.
A stock take indicates your inventory is worth over 40,000 E. I stop.
Oh, it's going well. More trash. Just lovely. And of course, we have to make sure we get our MK Scuzzadroid out. Almost forgot. And make sure these guys are always busy. Make more luxury goods. Because they're on a roll. They're making those really fast. Merchant ship, alright. Alright, looks good. Looks like our third cargo hold is filling up quite
has departed.
Quickly, so it looks like we might have to expand another one on this side over here once we're able to purchase one. No, you Scuzzadroid should be on the second floor picking up the trash. Again, small note here. You can actually right click on a Scuzzadroid and individually select what you want them to do, repair, build rooms, and recycle litter and whatnot. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set this guy on as a priority to clean stuff. And let's add more stuff for these guys to do in the factory, because they don't want to go home, they don't want to go to their wife and children, now they just want to stay in the factory and make more luxury goods. Looks like our cargo hold is very close to filling up now. I guess I never showed you this, so the little humor out, like the Scuzzadroid brings the package in. He has to wait for the cargo hold guy to put it in. Alright, Aurora, nice timing.
I've got some goods that'll make your eyes fall.
Cargo hold, sweet.
And when you hear our cheap I'm selling them, your ears will drop off and slide back and forth.
Alright.
A merchant ship has docked.
Get another cargo hold, and I really hope we can win the game with this last cargo hold, because I'm running out of walls, and I'm gonna have to delete my energy collector, and that's very, very dangerous. You don't want to do that once you have this kind of system going. You can do that in the start of the game when you have nothing but the energy collector, but you definitely don't want to be doing it when you've got a...
A merchant ship, there is a solar flare in progress. Shall I reconfigure the factory like has completed its production?
Oh, no you don't. You guys are getting back in there. More luxury goods for you to make. And we are so very, so very close. 88,000.
Stocktake indicates your inventory is worth over 40,000 E. I stopped counting about that, I'm afraid.
Alright, everything's looking good, nice and hot. Checking the inventory. Alright. Now I've seen this before, this seems to be a weird glitch with the game. You can see that there's a trail of hearts coming from the multi. I have no idea why that happens. It's a very strange bug. An amusing bug. At least it is not a great game-breaking bug.
More trash.
Sweet. Alright, got a trader coming in. Let's hope they've got something very, very expensive we can buy so we can finish and wrap this up. And dear God, we are getting even closer to our goal. Let's buy luxury goods. Yeah, give me all your luxury goods. We can bring it right over here. Any more stuff? Can I buy more stuff? Alright, there we go. Sweet. So very close, I can taste the victory in my mouth. 3,000 more energy. You're so very close, folks. So very close. Wait, am I supposed to be collecting 100,000 energy or 100,000 E energy worth of goods?
Has completed its production.
Oh dear God, I screw this up. Oh God, I'm gonna have to start selling all this stuff back just for money. I believe I have to make up 100,000 E, not 100,000 E in cargo hold. This counter threw me off like hell. Well, I mean, to a certain extent, I haven't really failed, but I guess let's set my playback through a little further.
A merchant ship has docked.
Alright, let's sell stuff like crazy. No, no. Alright, get out of here. Alright, we need to sell. Pronto.
A stock take indicates your inventory is worth over 40,000 E. I stopped counting after that, I'm afraid.
No, that was trash. Okay. Whoops. We need to sell. Where are those ships? And they're never around when you need to.
A merchant ship has departed.
Oh God, all this garbage. Keep in mind, folks, apparently aliens in the future are very, very dirty. Merchant ship, we need more ships in here. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually increase the price on these ports a little bit, so we have more money. And sell more stuff, we need to get rid of all this. We're on wholesale, you know, we're on like, store, sale, everything. Everything needs to go.
And I've got some goods that'll make your eyes fall out and roll on the floor. And when you have actually been selling them, your ears will...
We are selling so much stuff, we're almost halfway there, actually.
I see that you have goods of approximate value to bring your energy total to 100,000. Might I suggest selling your inventory?
Okay, yeah, wow, thanks for telling me that after I did all of that. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Game Mechanics, for making that tip advice come out after I made a terrible choice of gathering 100,000 E in just stuff and not money itself? Thank you. Trading. Now, I should be technically getting another comm sensor since we're not getting too much ships very often, but I'm lazy, so no. If you guys are probably wondering why the sickbay is so empty now, sickbay is empty because of. In episode 2, that was a specialized grave mission where a lot of people came in purposely sick. Practically everybody, really. But in normal Startopia, really, though, there isn't overly too much sick people to a certain degree, so most of the time you don't have to worry about it. And since we have a lot of medical goods, treatment is far more effective too, so less sick people, less sick all the time. I have something in my inventory. What is this? Probably garbage. Yep. It's like a towel that somebody puked on. And here we go. More electric goods. Take all my electric goods, please, please. I don't want my electric goods. Please buy more. Please buy more. Fine, be that way.
I see that you have goods of approximate value to bring your energy total to
100. Yeah, thanks for telling me. Yeah.
And avoid buying anything else.
You are so helpful, Val. Oh, yeah, 1,000, inventory, avoid buying anything else. You gotta have a lot of luxury goods. Alright, one more ship. I think one more ship will do it, actually. One more, if we get one more ship. We sell our luxury goods. I think we'll be very, very close. Practically done.
Dundership. Hello and welcome aboard. Please hurry up and come aboard. We really want to sell stuff.
A merchant ship has docked.
All right. There we go. Luxury goods. No! Why? Why thou have luxury goods? No. No. Oh, God. To wait for another ship and another Aurora deal.
The merchant ship has departed.
Fantastic, but we do have a giant blob of energy. Ooh. I could just stare at this ball of energy all day.
Stock take indicates your inventory is worth over 40,000 E. I stopped counting after that, I'm afraid.
Alright, another trade ship, please. Well, looks like I got another trader.
I see that you have goods of
approximate. Oh, total 100,000. Avoiding buying anything else.
There is a solar flare in progress. Shall I reconfigure the collector to gather some solar energy?
Now, let's hope this
trader received your reply.
Let's hope they like luxury goods. It looks like we're actually really close to our goal, even if not trading overly too much. Luxury goods! Oh yeah!
Your trading skills are quite superb. Perhaps one day you'll be as famous as Arona Dahl and twice as popular. Now to business. I have an offer from the Galactic Rehabilitation Authority. It appears they want someone to set up and run a convict rehabilitation center.
Well, anyway, thank you for watching. I'm terribly sorry how that dragged on there. I made that terrible mistake of making too much goods. Well, anyway, this has been my Startopia playthrough video. This is episode 3 of the Targ Collective, and I'll see you in the next video.
Targ Collective.